Good morning, students. This is Dharambir sir here again, and we are continuing with chapter 1, that is relations and functions. And today's topic is composition of functions and invertible functions. So let's start. So we are starting with the first topic, that is composition of functions. As you can see here, that let f from a to b and g from b to c be two functions, then the composition of f and g is denoted by g of f, defined as g of from a to c. Now we have f from a to b, g from b to c, and the composition g of is from a to c, that is first to third set, given by g of x is equal to g of fx. For every x belonging to A, that is none of the elements of first set A should be unpaired. Clear? In this case, we have two sets, two functions, f and g. First is from set A to B, and second function g from B to C. And the composition is from the first set A to the third set C. Clear? It is denoted by GOF, read as G of F or GOF. I simply call it as GOF. Now there are some important points to remember. First is, if F from A to B and G from B to C are 1-1, we have learned about 1-1 function or 2 function in the previous video. If F from A to B and G from B to C are 1-1, then GOF from A to C is also 1-1. A to C is also 1-1. Second point is, if f from A to B and g from B to C are onto, then gof from A to C is also onto. Remember the definition of onto function in the previous video. And the third point is that if f from x to y, g from y to z, and h from z to s are functions, then h of gof is equal to hog of f. Clear? That is, this simply follows the associative rule. If you have three functions, then the composition follows the associative property. Have you understood? So pause the video and note down the definition and these note point one. Coming to the next point, that is invertible function. A function f from x to y is defined to be invertible if there exists a function g from y to x. Now first one is from x to y, then the invertible function is from y to x, thus the inverse, such that g of x is equal to x and fog y is equal to y. We have learned about g of and fog in the previous slide, that is g of is composition of g and f, and fog is composition of f and g. Now g of x is equal to x and fog y is equal to y, then the function g is called inverse of f and is denoted by f inverse. If this criteria, that is g of x equals to x and fog y is equal to y, is satisfied, then the function g is called inverse of f and is denoted by f inverse. Or you can simply say that from this you can also conclude that f is also inverse of g. Clear? If g is inverse of f, then f is also inverse of g. Clear? Now certain points to remember. If f is invertible, then f must be 1-1 and onto. Clear? Second point is, if f is 1-1 and onto, then f must be invertible. Now this is very important, that there will be sums that when we have to prove that certain function is invertible. In that case, we have to simply prove that the given function is 1-1 and onto. And if we can prove that function to be 1-1 and onto, then it is invertible. Remember this point. Third is, we can prove a function to be invertible function by showing that f is 1-1 and onto. Now I have explained this in note 2. Fourth point is, let f from x to y and g from y to z be two invertible functions. Both are invertible. Then g of is also invertible, that is their composition is also invertible, with g of inverse equals to f inverse o g inverse. G of inverse is equal to f inverse o g inverse. So I hope you understood. So pause the video and note down the definitions. Now moving to the exercise. I hope you all have your textbook. So open exercise 1.3. Question 1. Let f from 1, 3, 4 to 1, 2, 5 and g from 1, 2, 5 to 1, 3 be given by f is given 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 1 and g is given 1, 3, 2, 3, 5, 1. We have to write down GOF. Now f is given, you can see that 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 1 and g is given 1, 3, 2, 3, 5, 1. Now I have just represented it in the form of arrow diagram. You can see that 1 is there to 2 and 2 is there to 3. It means element 1 of first set is related to element 3 of the third set. So GOF is from first to third, remember that definition. So 1 related to what? 3. So in GOF we get 1, 3. Now element 3 of the first set is related to element 1 of the third set. So in GOF we get 3, 1. And element 4 of the first set is related to element 3 of the third set. So in GOF we get 4, 3. If you are able to draw the arrow diagram, then finding GOF is very easy. I hope you understood. So pause and note down the solution. Next is question number 3. We have to find GOF and FOG. If, I solved the second part for you, fx is 8x cube and gx is x power 1 by 3. Now fx is equal to 8x cube and gx is equal to x cube. Now GOF x, definition was GOF is equal to what? G of fx. So in place of fx I have written 8x cube. So we got g of 8x cube. Now gx is equal to what? X power 1 by 3. So in place of x we have to replace 8x cube. So we get 8x cube power 1 by 3. So we get GOF x equals to 2x. Now FOG x. So again by definition FOG x is equal to what? F of gx and gx is equal to x power 1 by 3 as given in the question. Now we get f of x power 1 by 3 and fx is equal to what? 8x cube. So simply in place of x we have to put x power 1 by 3. So we get 8 multiplied with x power 1 by 3 whole power 3. So after solving we get FOG x equals to 8x. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Now moving to question number 4. If fx equals to 4x plus 3 upon 6x minus 5, we have to show that f of fx equals to x. And second part is what is the inverse of f. So this question is two part. First part, finding f of fx, f of x. Now fx is given. F of fx means what? By definition it is f of fx. And in place of fx I replaced 4x plus 3 upon 6x minus 4. So we get f of 4x plus 3 upon 6x minus 4. Now this f again, so putting this 4x plus 3 upon 6x minus 4 entirely in place of x, you get 4 into this plus 3 upon 6 into this minus 4. So simply solving addition subtraction of fraction we get that f of x equals to what? X. Then the first part is proved. I hope you understood. So pause and note down the solution. Moving to the second part, we have to find the inverse of the given function. Now we know that fx equals to y. By taking inverse you get x equals to what? F inverse y. So whenever we have to find the value of inverse, so simply put fx equals to y and you will get x as f inverse y. So f inverse y is your required inverse. So let y is equal to 4x plus 3 upon 6x minus 4. This is our fx. So after cross multiplication and solving these two equations, we get x equals to what? 4y plus 3 upon 6y minus 4. And this x is equal to f inverse y. Clear? So we get f inverse y is equal to 4y plus 3 upon 6y minus 4. And if you closely look at the function we got, 4y plus 3 upon 6y minus 4, this is the same function as given in the question with the different variable only. Only with the variable is changed, function is same. So we can conclude that inverse of the given function f is f itself. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Moving to question number 5. We have state with reason whether the following functions have inverse. I am solving third part for you. We have h as 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 7, 9, 1, 11 and h is given 2, 7, 3, 9, 4, 11, 5, 13. That is 2 is related to 7, 3 related to 9, 4 related to 11 and 5 related to 13. Now as you must see that in the given function each element of 2, 3, 4, 5 has distinct images in f. Okay? Distinct images. 2 has the image 7, 3 has the image 9, 4 has the image 11 and 5 has the image 13. Therefore by definition of 1, 1 function h is 1, 1. since different elements have different images. Clear? Therefore, h is 1, 1. Now, similarly, each element of second set 7, 9, 11, 13 has some pre-image in the first set 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see that 7 has the pre-image 2, 9 has the pre-image 3, 11 has the pre-image 4, and 13 has the pre-image 5. Then none of the elements of second set are unpaired. Therefore, by the definition of onto function, h is 1, 1, sorry, h is onto. Hence, we get h is 1, 1 and onto. And while discussing the properties, I told you that whenever we have to prove that a function is invertible, we have to simply prove that the function is 1, 1 and onto. So, since here the function h is 1, 1 and onto, therefore it is invertible. Clear? Now, remember this point. It is very simple. Simply prove that the given function is 1, 1, given function is onto. And if you can prove the function to be 1, 1 and onto, it is going to be invertible. Clear? So pause the video and note down the solution. Coming to question number 9. Now you can see question number 6, 7, 8 and 9. All these sums are same. And remember that question 9, some of these types are asked in your exams. And this one is very, very important sum for 4 marks. So question 9 is, consider f from R plus, that is positive real numbers, to minus 5 to infinite, given by fx is given 9x square plus 6x minus 5. We have to show that f is invertible with f inverse y equal to given. Clear? So first is we have to show that f is invertible. Second, we have to prove that f inverse is equal to this one. Now invertible. Remember the properties that whenever we have to show that a function is invertible, we have to simply show that it is 1, 1 and onto. So starting with the first one. Now we have fx equals to 9x square plus 6x minus 5. So 1, 1 is what? Fx1 equals to fx2, and we have to ultimately prove it, that elements x1 and x2 are equal. Now fx1 is 9x1 square plus 6x1 minus 5, and fx2 is 9x2 square plus 6x2 minus 5. Now I have completed both the sides of the equation into whole squares by adding 1 and subtracting 1. Now we get 3x1 plus 1 whole square minus 6 and 3x2 plus 1 whole square minus 6. After solution, we are finding that x1 and x2 are equal. So we have taken fx1 equals to fx2 and proved that x1 and x2 are equal. So fx1 equals to fx2 implying that x1 and x2 are equal. Hence f is 1, 1. Done. So we have proved the function to be 1, 1. Moving to the second part, which is onto. Now onto was that for every y there must exist some x. Clear? So let fx equals to y. So we get y is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 4. So we have already converted this in whole square. So we get y is equal to 3x plus 1 whole square minus 6. So by solving this equation, we get the value of x as under y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3. So remember this point. Whenever we have to prove 1, 2, simply take fx equals to y. And from that equation, find the value of x. So we can see that for each value of y as a pre-image, x which is equal to under y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3 in the domain. Therefore, by definition of onto function, f is onto. Clear? Now, since we have proved f as 1, 1 and onto, therefore f is invertible. Remember this point, that whenever we have to prove that a function is invertible, simply prove that it is 1, 1 and onto. Now we have second part, we have to prove that f inverse y. Now since fx equals to y, so we get f inverse y is equal to x. So f inverse y is equal to x, and x is equal to what? We've already calculated x as under y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3. So we get f inverse y equals to under y plus 6 minus 1 upon 3, which was the required inverse function. I hope you understood the solution of question 9. Solve it 1 times, 2 times, 3 times, how many times, but solve it. Because this is a very, very, very important question. So pause and note down the solution. Next is question 10. Let f from x to y be an invertible function. We have to show that f has unique inverse. Clear? Now this is the truth, that we have to, whenever a function is invertible, its inverse is unique. Now it is given that f is invertible, then gauf x equals to x and fog y is equal to y. While explaining the definition, I have told you these two points, that whenever a function is invertible, then gauf x is equal to x and fog y is equal to y. Now, to contradict the fact, let there be two universes, G1 and G2. Clear? And I am going to simply prove that G1 and G2 are same. So if we have two universes G1 and G2, then fog1y is equal to y and fog2y is equal to y. Since both are equal to y, it means fog1y and fog2y both are equal. So f of g1y is equal to f of g2y by definition of compositional function fogx equals to what? F of gx. And since f is invertible, so f will be 1 1 1 2. So fx1 equals to fx2 implies what? x1 equals to fx2 x2. So f g1y and f g2y will imply that g1y and g2y are equal, hence we are getting g1 equals to g2. So we have taken two inverses g1 and g2 and proved that both are equal. So it means invertible functions cannot have two different inverse functions. Therefore f has a unique inverse. I hope I am clear. So pause and note down the solution. Question 11 is, consider f from 1, 2, 3 to abc, given by f1 equals to a, f2 is equal to b and f3 is equal to c. We have to find f inverse and show that f inverse ka inverse equals to f. And read the question 12 also. In that question also we have to prove f inverse ka inverse equals to f. So simply in that question you can take the example like question number 11. So question 11, we have f1 equals to a, f2 is equal to b and f3 is equal to c. So simply taking inverse, f inverse a is equal to 1, f inverse b is equal to 2 and f inverse c is equal to 3. So we already find f inverse. Now taking the inverse of f inverse, so we will get f inverse ka inverse 1 equals to what? A. F inverse inverse 2 is equal to b and f inverse inverse 3 is equal to c. Done. Now look at equation 1 and 2. In these equation, their right hand sides are equal. It means the left hand sides will be also equal. So we will get f1 equals to f inverse ka inverse 1. It means f is equal to f inverse ka inverse. Clear? f2 is equal to f inverse ka inverse 2. So f is equal to f inverse ka inverse. f3 is equal to c and f inverse ka inverse 3 is equal to c. So f is equal to f inverse ka inverse. So from 1 and 2, we are getting that f inverse inverse is equal to f. So in the same way, you can take an example and show that in question number 12, f inverse is equal to f inverse ka inverse is equal to f. I hope you understood. So pause the video and note down the solution. And the remaining sums, solve by yourself and don't forget the examples. Thank you. All the best. Good morning, students. This is Dharambir sir here.